Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. So recently, we announced that we are going to release a 15-year-old short film, and that we did this using artificial intelligence and some tricks up our sleeve in DaVinci Resolve. And in today's video, I'll show you one of the tricks we did with the artificial intelligence, and that's making this shot right here. So instead of just using the original footage, I'm going to reshoot the clip using me and my iPhone, and I'm going to use the Blackmagic camera app, which, by the way, had a pretty good update not that long ago. So if you're using that app to capture your footage, please do go and update that. That's what this video is going to be all about, and I'll show you how you can do this inside of DaVinci Resolve in Fusion with the artificial intelligence and all of that good stuff. So again, if you want to see the short film, it's going to premiere on the 1st of December this year. If you see this video sometime in the future, you know, you can just click up here in the top corner and you can see the film. It's a fun little film, I think. Anyway, let's just get right to it.
Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and I'm going to show you how we did the fly effect in the film. And what we have here is a AI-generated plane and a quick shot just done on an iPhone. And if we just go into the color page, you can see that there is a little grade on the shot itself. Nothing too fancy. And the way we're going to make this is we are going to take our fly or our airplane or our jet, and we're going to move that up a couple of layers, and then we are going to push Alt and drag, and we're going to duplicate the first layer here with me. And we're going to make three copies of that. And then we're going to highlight everything, right click, and we are going to make a new Fusion clip. And let's just jump into Fusion then. So here we have it, but we are going to take all the merge and everything and just delete that. The first clip here we have is just the background. The second we have here, if we push one on the keyboard, we can see is going to be this clip here. And if I push function and F2 on Mac or just F2 on PC, if you're using PC, we are going to rename the clip, and this is going to be man, like that. We have that here. This one, we are going to have a look at what we have. Again, the same thing. Again, renaming this just to make things easier. We are going to call this house, like that. And the last one must be the airplane or the jet. Yes, it is. So we are just going to call that jet, like that. So let's get started. First thing I want to do is actually to take the jet here and start to do something with that. And we're going to use a multi-merge node, which is this new one, pretty new one for DaVinci Resolve. We're going to use that, and we're going to drag that in between the media in and the media out. And then we are taking our jet, and we're going to connect that. Like so. And then we're just going to remove everything. And we're going to do that by pushing shift spacebar. And we're just going to search for the magic mask, which is right here. And I'm going to add that in. Like that. And we're just going to go up here, and we're going to draw a line on our airplane. And now we took too much. And actually, if you have the airplane in the first viewer as well, we can just go over and draw on that here. And that's actually going to make it a little bit easier, something like that. And if we have something we don't want, you can either go up in the inspector and you can just go here and change the stroke mode from add to subtract. And we can take out this part, for instance. And if you want to add something, you can just push add. So we can add in just a little here, something like that. Okay, So that's the basic of that. What I then want to do is I want to add in a transform, which is right here, because we want our plane to move. So I'll be at the beginning here. And I'm just going to go up to my transform, and in the center Y position, I'm going to take out my airplane. So it's out of frame, like that. I'm just going to push in the keyframe, and then let's just go a little forward. So when I do react, I want the plane to pass. So I'm going to put in a keyframe again, and I'll go a little forward here, like that. And now, let's say I want it to pass around frame 17 or something like that. Again, into the transform, and I'm just going to move it all the way through, like that. This is something happening with the magic mask. If you do some kind of movement or something, it's going to erase the mask. And the way to fix that would be to go back to magic mask, push this icon here in the middle, and track one more time. So it's just going to track the whole movement one more time. So now DaVinci have done the thing. And if we just push play, we can see that our airplane is moving to the scene, but of course the illusion is broken because it flies through me and through the roof. However, that we are going to fix. So first up, one thing I want to fix, of course, is that the airplane itself doesn't really blend in very well. However, we can fix that pretty fast by taking a color adjustment and putting that in between the jet and the magic mask. Like so, and in the inspector, I'm just going to take the saturation and drag that down. Something like that looks pretty good, I think, or at least better. So let's continue. So now I'm going to take the man layer, and I'm going to pipe that into the multi-merge. And again, I'm going to push shift spacebar, and I'm going to add in a magic mask. And then I'm just going to track me, drawing on me, like so. And I'm just going to track forward and back. And again, DaVinci will just do its thing. So with the tracking done, we have this little thing right now. Airplane, and it flies behind me, but still we have a little issue. We have the issue right here with the house. And we're going to do the exact same thing once again. Connecting the house layer down to the merge, pushing shift spacebar, and adding in a magic mask, like that. Just want to take this part of the roof, like this, and I'm just going to track this forward and backward yet again. And then DaVinci did its thing, and now we have this very little, or pretty short clip with the jet plane flying through the scene here, and let's have a look here. There we go, behind the roof and behind me. And we're just going to pause it here, and I'm just going to use my arrow key so I can go frame by frame here. So one last thing to add would be to add in the smoke elements here. And we're going to do that pretty simple by adding in a fast noise. I have a fast noise here, and I'm just going to add that into the multi-merge node. And now if we go into the multi-merge node, you'll see that we have all our layers, and our fast noise is the top layer, but I don't want that to be our top layer. I want that to be underneath the jet layer. So I can just take this and drag that down here. So now that is there. Here I am with the fast noise layer. However, I'm going to add in a mask here, which I have right here. So in theory, we could draw two lines of smoke, but I'm just, for the sake of this tutorial's length, going to draw one. So let's make something like, I know it's not totally realistic, but however, we're just going to draw something like this. And I'm going to put this into the fast noise. So now we can't really see anything, but let's just change that. So I'll go into the fast noise, and I can change the detail here of that. the contrast, and also I could change the feet a little bit and the seed rate. And if we go up to the color, we can change the colors. So we can, for instance, go into this and make it a little darker, something like that. I think that looks pretty good. However, we are going to go back to the polygon, and in the polygon, we are going to soften the edges quite a bit. So we have like this smoke effect, like that. And if we wanted, we could do some kind of a border. So we're going to bump that up just a little bit, something like that. So now it would have this effect. And what we're going to do, we're just going to do a super simple animation here on the polygon, actually. So I'm just going to go into the center, and I'm going to put in a keyframe right here. And now I'm just going to use the arrow keys to go a frame forward. So I'm just going to go a frame forward, and then I'm just going to move the center so it follows the airplane or the jet plane, like that, something like that. And you know, I could continue just to make this move slowly, something like that. And let's just quickly go back here, and I'm going to do the same thing, keeping the smoke behind the jet. Like that. So now that is actually added in. One last thing to do would be to go into the multi-merge node. And then I'm going to take the jet layer, and I'll go into the settings. And in the settings, I'm just going to add in motion blur. And we can, of course, make this look a little bit better. We can change the quality and stuff like that. So I'm just going to bump down the quality, actually. And the shutter angle, because I don't want it to be too motion blurry, but just a little, I'm just going to take the shutter angle and put that quite a bit down. So we just have a very little movement on the airplane. So that's how we did the effect in the film. If you want to see the film, it will be available on the 1st of December. If you see this video after December, it's going to be linked up in the top corner. So I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.